Today I would like to introduce to you a movie which, according to my students, is one of the most important historical movies in Central and Eastern Europe, and everyone should watch it. Some call it the most important movie about Poland history as well. The plot is set at the turn of 14th and 15th centuries. Those groundbreaking events are the background of a love story between Danusia, the daughter of Jurand of Spychów, and Zbyszko of Bogdaniec. Do you already know the movie? If you don't, I will only tell you which scene from the movie is considered the best and the most remarkable. It is the very impressive final scene of the Battle of Grunwald, in which the Polish army sings the first Polish national anthem, Bogu Rodzica, Mother of God. Yes, I'm talking about the movie Knights of the Teutonic Order, which was based on a book written by a Polish winner of a Nobel Prize in Literature, Henryk Sienkiewicz. Do you know any other Polish writers who received the prize? They are Władysław Reymont, Czesław Miłosz, Wisława Szymborska and Olga Tokarczuk. But let's go back to the Knights. It was originally published as a series in a magazine between 1897 and 1900. As a novel in 1900. The director omitted many strands from the novel, which seems unavoidable, and corrected some historical facts. But actually, do you know who the Knights of the Teutonic Order were and why they were important for the history of Poland? The Teutonic Order, actually Order of Brothers of the German House of Saint Mary in Jerusalem, was one of the three biggest orders established during Crusades from the 20th century. The Teutonic Order Knights not only did organize their nation very efficiently, but they also had great ambitions. In the 13th century, they conquered many lands by playing political games and falsifying documents, for example, basing on a false treaty of Kruszwitz, they obtained Chełmno land. The situation changed in the 14th century, when the first armed conflict between Poland and the Knights emerged. Again, in the history of Poland, Pomerania was a cause of fight. Margrave of Brandenburg, belonging to the Roman Empire, took over this land. Władysław Łokietek, who was the king back then, was too weak to fend off the attack, so he asked for the support from the Knights. The Knights managed to recapture the land, but then they refused to return it to the king. They were held before papal court in Inowrocław, and according to the verdict, Pomerania was to be returned to Poland. But the Knights were not planning on doing so. In the following years, they formed an alliance with the John of Bohemia, the king of the Duchy of Bohemia. Poland was attacked from both the south and the north, but luckily the king of Bohemia was too slow. The Knights of the Teutonic Order had to retreat, but on their way back they burned down and destroyed some castle towns, for example Konin. In September 1331, King Wojciech attacked the part of the Teutonic Order which was still on the Polish ground. Having been defeated, the Knights had to flee from Poland. Kazimir the Great, Wojciech's son, signed a peace treaty in Kalisz with the Knights. It was then called Perpetual Peace. As a result of a treaty, Poland regained Kujawia, but they had to forego Pomerania, which was controlled by the Teutonic Order. Unfortunately, the peaceful period did not last long. Ulrich von Jungingen, who became the head of the order, did not want to maintain the truce with Poland. Due to the marriage of Jadwiga and Władysław Jagiełło, Poland strengthened relations with Lithuania, which the order was afraid of. At the beginning of the 15th century, the conflict with the order intensified. They were parting Samogitia with a rebellion started in 1409. Poland and Lithuania supported Samogitia as they wanted the rebellion to weaken the Knights. The Teutonic Order, on the other hand, was supported by the King of Hungary and countries of the Western Europe. The main castle of the Teutonic Order and their headquarters were located in Malbork. The Polish king demanded the land to be returned to Poland, the compensation be paid, and Samogitia be free. The order did not accept the terms, obviously, so the armies of Poland, Lithuania, and the Teutonic Order met by the village of Grunwald. The Polish army was said to have had about 29 to 35,000 of soldiers, when the knights had about 21,000. On the 15th of July, the Polish, Lithuanian and the Teutonic armies stood opposite to each other. Ulrich von Jungingen and his army were waiting in a blistering sun. Jagiełło hoped that the knights waiting in the sun while having their armors on will weaken. The head of the order decided to humiliate the king by sending him two bear swords without sword covers. The Polish king decided to attack. The battle lasted until the evening, and for the better part of it, the Polish-Lithuanian army was winning. But it changed after a few hours, when the knights almost seized the Polish banner. But the Lithuanian army ringed the knights. By the end of the battle, the Polish soldiers ravaged the Teutonic camp. During the battle, all of the most prominent members of order, so-called the elders, died. Among them was the head of the order, Ulrich von Jungingen. The Polish king was so honorable as to send the body of the defeated master to Malbork to let the members of the order bury him with respect. Jagiełło proved he was a competent strategist and a king who was not to be ignored. The Polish standing was elevated at the Jagiellonians, became of the greatest European dynasties. It is really worth watching the last scene of the knights with the Battle of Grunwald, and it is definitely worth to see the castle in Malbork, which is still standing and which is one of the most beautiful castles in Poland. So if you will ever be in the North Poland, you have to definitely go there. The Knights of the Teutonic Order is one of the most important Polish movies, and it is a top of the list of the movies directed before 1989 with the greatest audience, 32 millions of viewers. But the movie has a drawback, a difficult archaic language. It is easier to watch it with English subtitles, which contain a more modern language. I hope you will enjoy the show. I hope you will enjoy the night. This podcast was recorded as a part of the project 100 Faktów z Historii Polski, które każdy cudzoziemiec znać powinien, which are being financed by the National Agency of the Academic Exchange as a part of the project promotion of the Polish language.